all responders. Mr. Phonehands are out of control. Evacuate civilians. And take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, you'll have to reboot the server. Again.
Welcome to the party.
Initialize scanning protocol. tech machine.
Responder team, proceed to the ag center and get to the mainframe. You need to reset the farmhand targeting parameters. That should keep our people safe in the area. Be careful.
Ah! with smarts and a little luck, you'll do just fine out there. With smarts and a little luck, you'll do just fine out there. It sure is great to see living human beings again. That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you. While you're here, why not grab a stim pack or two? Volunteer, if you need supplies, Bob's got you covered. That overseer lady said more people would be coming. It's nice to meet you.
Overseer's log, town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice, angry, tortured. We are one. One what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the Responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but someone's got to know where the missile silos are and how to secure them. The Responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Chloe's my pet. Or maybe I'm hers. I'm not sure. document our stories. For posterity, you know. Seems like a fine idea. So, hi. I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoga, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoga to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone. Kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. Boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse too. So, take time and care. Well, time, care, and science.
Returning to normal operations. Terminating search.
winters here, born and raised in this very town. Lent my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see. Helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrong. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how? Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind a dumpster. You ought to cook that first, I warned him. Seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly, and I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But till then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?